My name's Tony, and I'm here with the Everyday Counts program. Thank you for joining me. And we have an hour together for chair yoga. And today's class is purely seated in the chair. So for those of you who are not keen to come down to the earth and stay in your chair for stability, then this class is for you. Making sure that chair you're on is safe and stable and comfortable for you. And let's get going. So, choosing a place that you want to start your practice. I always encourage people to decide for themselves whether to use the support of the chair behind you or to sit away from the chair, strengthening through the center line of the body, whichever feels comfortable for you, and you can always come in and out of both of those shapes. Feet at a comfortable distance. And we're not comparing our body to anybody else's. We're all put together completely uniquely. And this is about giving yourself permission to do what feels good for you rather than thinking that it has to be a certain way or you're mimicking somebody else. So, picking up those toes, spreading them wide. It doesn't matter whether you've got shoes on, socks on, or bare feet. Pick up the balls of your feet if you feel stable enough. You get that nice flex through the ankle and then stretch the soles of your feet as if they could get just a millimeter wider and longer. And then as we replace the balls of the feet down, unless they weren't lifted, let's let the toes drift down nice and softly. We start to put our awareness down on the soles of our feet, noticing the texture underneath them. And that might be your sock, it might be the floor, it might be a mat. A great way to do this, to wake up the awareness in the soles of your feet, is to close the eyes or soften or lower the gaze. And we start to be able to place all of our awareness down on the soles of our feet, awakening that. You might notice the texture, the softness, the smoothness. And then with that awareness down on your feet, gently, evenly, left to right, as best as you can, start to push down into the earth. Just about 10 or 15%. So the muscles of your legs start to awaken. And then you might even notice that through the lower belly and the core, lifting the crown of the head up just a millimeter more. Keep that pressure up. And then on an exhale, allow the pressure to soften. So the legs are just suspended there, held and supported by the earth. Take your awareness up to your seat, where your seat meets the chair. And if you wiggle from side to side, depending on the softness of your chair, you may be able to sense into the two sitting bones, which are the two bony bits. If you lean off towards one side and then the other, then right underneath the pelvis. And depending on how you're sitting, you might feel this differently. So if you're sitting with your shoulders behind you, you might feel this as if you're sitting towards the back of your pelvis. If you're sitting more forward, you might feel it underneath the tops of your thighs more. Or sitting as high as you can, so your shoulders are more or less over your hips, your head balanced over the top. We're sitting right on top of those sitting bones. So, with that in your awareness, imagine it if you can't feel it, and then move a little bit forward, back, side to side, and come to a place that feels like center for you. Don't worry about what it looks like, what feels like center. Take a breath in, and on an exhale, allow the upper body weight to sit down into the chair, kind of like when we push down with the feet. So we really allow our weight to sit heavy into the chair underneath us and maybe behind us. And then we really ground down. So from the pelvis down to the feet, we're really connected downwards towards the earth. From there, we're starting to ignite the center of the body. So imagine that your torso gets a little bit longer, heart lifting. Crown of the head is reaching up towards the ceiling as if you were balancing something on the crown of your head. Roll the shoulders back and down a couple of times, releasing as much much tension as you can. And then when it feels right, let the shoulders settle away from the ears so that there's space through the neck. For most of us, drawing the head back in space, tucking the chin a little, is going to lengthen the back of the neck. So you can check that out and see how it feels for you. So we've got our head balanced more or less over the heart space, over the hips. Take a breath in when you're ready. Keep the shape as best as you want to, and exhale, let the tension go. So let that go a couple of times with the breath. And make any adjustments you need to accommodate for your body, for it to feel comfortable, and this seat to feel sustainable. As if all we did for the next hour was just sit here, it would feel like you could. Beautiful, knowing that any time in the class today, adjust and adapt things to feel better for your body rather than thinking there's a right or wrong way to do this. There's no way you can do this wrong. So from here, if you haven't already, soften the gaze, lower the gaze, or close the eyes if you're comfortable and stable. We're going to take this time just to tune inwards. And notice how you're feeling today. If there are emotions present, if you're feeling anything about the class, the day ahead, the week ahead, maybe you're still mulling over something that has already happened this week or today. Just be honest, let it all come in, and try not to resist anything or have any opinions about anything. That's the hardest thing. Notice if there's a lot on your mind. And again, welcome it all in. Try to stay as neutral as possible. Watching the thoughts like, I seem to be really worried about that thing. Or this is really, you know, going round and round inside myself. And then we'll come inside the body. So dipping the awareness inside, taking the awareness to the crown of your head, and then slowly sweeping your awareness down through your body bit by bit, noticing places of tightness, of discomfort, places that feel tender, places that you need to take extra care of while moving. Try and stay away from the stories as to why. So if your shoulder is particularly loud today, try and stay away from the, that's because of that injury or because of the gardening I did yesterday. Just, my right shoulder really feels like it needs a little extra care today. Good to know. And continue your journey on through your body, all the way down to once more the soles of your feet, feeling that texture, that support underneath them. And we're going to do that one more time. So taking your awareness up to the crown of your head, and then this time sweeping your awareness down through your body, noticing the quiet places, the ease, places that maybe you don't notice. So if your right shoulder is very loud, then what about your left shoulder? What about a different place in your right shoulder? So taking your awareness down through your body, noticing the quiet places, the places where you feel strong and you feel comfortable. And it's a different mindset if all of your life you're normally focused on the things that are loud or uncomfortable. So it's a different way of being. And we'll send our awareness down to the soles of our feet, and then expand your awareness into your whole being now, from the soles of your feet to the crown of your head, to the tips of your fingers, inside body and outside body too, and just notice as best as you can the energy levels you're working with today. Again, staying away from the stories, just notice, I feel a little like this. I feel about a 60% today of energy, or maybe it's a 10% of energy. And this is all information that we take into our practice. So if you're feeling tired, you do less, you rest more. If you're feeling fully full of beans and your body's feeling strong and fantastic, we can take that into our practice too. So as you notice that, to tune in and close your eyes, start to notice the breath within your body. And as we do that, normally we start to deepen the breath. Consider breathing in and out through the nose. And if that's not comfortable for you for any reason today, no big deal, just to breathe in an easy way. You can breathe in and out through your nose. It's one of the quickest ways to regulate the nervous system. Even if it feels strange at first, do your best, check it out. If it's uncomfortable, let it go. Breathe in your natural, easy way. We start to deepen the inhale and lengthen the exhale. Nice and smooth, as steady as we can make it. Maybe your breath feels very small, very short. Try not to force anything. And yoga is about starting to move slowly towards something. So this is not about trying to force the breath to get bigger. We're opening the body up to a possibility of longer breath with no expectation. So we've got that steadier, longer breath, even if it's just a beat longer than we started with. And again, letting go of any straining of the breath. So if all we were doing is sitting here and breathing together, then that would be enough. So this longer, smoother, softer quality of breath, it's one of the best breaths we have for regulating the nervous system, for helping build our awareness in our body, and also helping reduce pain and discomfort. So at any time, you can always come back to the stillness, this breath, this mindfulness of that steadiness and ease. I'm going to root down through those feet one more time in the seat, rising up from there. So we're readjusting our posture. Once again, the shoulders roll back and down. The chin tucks a little, maybe the back of the head draws back in space. And we breathe, inhaling and exhaling, noticing that breath coming and going. This is the inhale on the exhale. Let's guide our gaze to one side. Inhale to center and gaze into the opposite side. Keep the collarbones nice and broad, so everything from the collarbones down as we go side to side is still and stable. If it feels comfortable for you and you feel stable on your chair, you can soften the gaze, close the eyes. As we just go side to side, making sure you're not holding the breath, especially at the end of that exhale, we're trying to push your body. Let's take another two here, either side, easing the body into that movement, gentle and smooth. And the next time we come back to center, we'll keep it there. I'm mirroring you, and we're gonna take that right hand down, give it a little shake, nice ease there. And we're gonna circle that shoulder in one direction, drawing circles in the air. Inhaling, that shoulder lifts, exhaling, rolling back and down. Noticing how that feels. And then we'll pause and take that round in the opposite direction. Nice and smooth. A steady breath and a steadier movement as we can. No momentum here, just control. Rest if you need to. Let's take another one or two here in your own time. Dangling that hand down. Take that hand in a tight or soft fist and we'll circle through that wrist. One direction, maybe some areas that feel super tight, but also notice the quieter areas where the range of motion is easier. Let's pause and take that round in the opposite direction. option to stay there or start to move from the shoulder. Keeping the joints easy as you lift the palm to any height. Exhaling, that palm comes down. The option is here, the left hand can support you in the chair if the right hand wants to come up and over, finding that length through the right side of the body. And you can either support yourself with that left hand. If you feel supported enough through your core, you can just dangle that left hand and that corset of muscles around your core is doing a whole lot more. Two more here. Keep the breath flowing, that smooth and steady breath as best as you can in and out through the nose or your comfortable breath. Next time that right hand comes down, we're going to give it a little wiggle. Releasing any tension, and then taking that hand back to support. The left hand is next to you, and we're circling with that left shoulder, just easing the shoulder into the movement. Don't worry if this side is very different from the other side. Please adjust any movement to work with your body. That means doing less repetitions or every other one, or just imagining the movement, and that's perfect. Keep the breath steady. On the next exhale, let's take that down and then round in the opposite direction. Smooth and steady as best as you can. You might feel this in very different places of your body. Just be aware, no judgment. Any discomfort, adjust the movement or rest if it doesn't feel like it's right for you. Next exhale, let's pause there. Come back to center, broaden the collarbones. Left hand in a tight or soft fist, and we're circling through that wrist one direction. Noticing how that feels. You might not feel it only in the wrist. It might slide up your forearm or go down towards your knuckles. And let's pause and take that in the opposite direction when you're ready. Just being very gentle with the body, befriending the body, rather than working against it. And then we'll release those fingers, give them a little wiggle if that feels good. We'll turn the palm out from the elbow, inhaling up, exhaling, pushing down as if through honey. We're still learning to rise through the body. Option to stay there, option to start to move from the shoulder. Keeping those joints nice and easy, shoulders, elbows, wrists, fingers and thumbs. That right hand can support you on the chair or dangle, depending on what feels most stable to you. And those left fingertips can come up and overhead. Keeping that left hip nice and grounded so we get the length through the left side of the body. Keep the breath flowing. Always building your awareness to what feels good for you. Let's take two more here. Rooting down through the feet and both sets of sit bones. Breath is steady as you can make it. And then we'll come all the way back to center. Give yourself a little wiggle. We'll take those hands back to support. Rooting to rise here. On the in-breath, we're drawing the heart forward as the elbows come back, drawing the shoulder blades towards each other. So we've got this extension through the front of the body. On the exhale, as we push the fingertips towards the knees, push the back of the ribs towards or into the back of the chair. Inhaling, we've got extension in the spine. Exhaling, flexion of the spine. A little or a lot goes a long way. You get to decide how much movement feels good to you. Keep that movement really steady. If you want to add on into the cervical spine, lift the chin on the inhale with a length through the back of the neck, so we're not just compressing. On the exhale, chin draws in towards the chest and we ground. Bring that down into your legs on the inhale. Imagine dragging the heels back towards the legs of the chair. On the exhale, push down into the floor, both feet evenly like we did in the beginning. Inhaling and exhaling. Noticing how that feels. If you want to add on, let's get some on the inhale, right arm up, left arm down. We're drawing the arms back into space. That's the inhale. On the exhale, meeting the fingertips in front of us, gaze goes down, and then opposite. Left arm up, right arm down, and reaching behind you. And we get that opening up through the chest, all the way down through the fingertips. And again, the most focus here is on the flexion and extension of the spine. Let's take four more breaths in your own time. Rest when you need to. Be gentle with yourself. And more or less, one more breath to go, depending on your length of breath. Please take your time. And we're coming all the way back to center, rolling through the shoulders, anything that feels good here. I'm going to take the palms towards the chest, thumbs can be linked if that feels comfortable for you, and lift the heart into the palms of the hand. So it's just a gentle lifting with a little extension through the thoracic spine, chin's drawn in, and again, the back of the neck is long. Imagine that the back of your pelvis, your shoulder blades, and the base of your skull are all resting on an imaginary wall behind you. Root down through your feet and seat. Get very clear with both sit bones being heavy in the chair. We'll keep them there. This is the inhale. On the exhale, we're going to tip to one side, keeping that opposite hip grounded, inhaling up and exhaling to the other side. Now the go-to here is normally to let one shoulder come forward, one shoulder back, but we're going to try and keep them as even as possible. And that inhale, shoulders over hips, exhaling, tilting to one side. And this is not bigger is better here, so it's much better to keep a smaller controlled movement than it is to get as far as we can, but we're kind of collapsing over to the one side and we need momentum to bring us back. So nice and steady movements, building that range of motion through the lateral flexion of the spine and control through the corset of core. Option to stay here, option when you come over to one side, we'll stay there three breaths, rooting down through the opposite hip, drawing back in space and breathing. If you feel like the breath is halting, then bring yourself up a little more. Notice if you're sitting more to one side than the other, even that out. And then on the inhale, we'll come up to center, over to the other side, the opposite side. Option in movement or stay for three breaths. Collarbones wide, heart is lifted, chin tucked, and the breath is steady. Both feet and the sides of the pelvis are rooted. Staying for the last exhale. On the inhale, we're coming all the way back up to center and releasing the palms down. Big breath in, exhaling it out. Okay, from here, we're going to dangle that right hand down. We've already been here. Rooting to rise, steady the breath, turning that right palm forward. On the inhale, moving from the shoulder, we're going to lift that palm up towards shoulder height, turn the palm down and lower it, maybe by the hip, maybe even back behind you, depending on your range of motion. Palm forward and up on the inhale, shoulder height, exhale, palm down, maybe even back behind you. Just noticing what that feels like in your shoulder. Don't worry about the angle. If your arm needs to be a little further away from your body, then work with your body, not against it. Noticing how this feels, option to stay. Option to lift that right palm up, and we're gonna keep it there. And then on the exhale, holding the palm up as if you have something precious on top of it, we're gonna take it over to the right. Inhaling back to center, exhaling palm down, maybe even back behind the head. That's the movement. Inhaling up, hold. Exhaling, twisting, take your gaze with the palm. Come back to center on the inhale and exhale down. When we twist, that right shoulder is coming back, left shoulder coming forward. Only go as far as the breath is guiding you. And we're never really pushing past the breath at all. Noticing how that feels as we ease the body into that movement. You can glance over that right shoulder. Let's take two more here. Keeping that left foot rooted, left hip down as we twist to the right. Center, right hand comes back to support any intuitive movement. You need to release tension, go ahead. And then the left arm dangles down, palm facing forward, shoulder blade drawn back towards the spine. On the inhale, we sweep that arm from the shoulder up to shoulder height, palm down on the exhale, taking that hand down, maybe back behind the hip. Gentle sweeping motion, very controlled. Noticing if you need to adjust anything. Keep the breath going. And this is an option, staying here. If you want to, coming into the twist, lifting on the inhale and staying. On the exhale, we're taking that arm up towards the left, inhaling back to center, and taking the arm down, maybe back behind you. Gentle movement, always guided by the breath. Breath steady and smooth. Notice how this feels in your body. And let's take one more. When you're ready, and any kind of intuitive movement to release tension, let's go ahead there. And from here, we're going to take those feet a little bit wider, external rotation. So making sure that it feels comfortable for you, we're rooting to rise. Don't worry if your external rotation is different one side to another. Keeping the heart facing forward and making sure you feel stable above all else. Big breath in, exhaling it out. Bring the hands in front of you, and we're going to interlace those hands. Taking the palms about heart height and palms down. Take a breath in when you're ready. And on that steady breath, we're going to push down on that exhale. So bent elbows or towards straight. On the inhale, we're sweeping those arms up in front of us, maybe overhead, elbows bent or straight, turning the palms down at the top of the breath, exhaling all the way down like you're pushing down through molasses or through a marshmallow, inhaling all the way up to your height, exhaling, turning that down, pushing down as if resistance. If you feel stable here, keep the breath going at your own rate, and to lower the gaze, soften the gaze, or close the eyes. Let's take three more full breaths here. Slowing the breath, steadying and smoothing the rhythm. Down to the thighs. If you need to make any adjustments, please do. We're going to stay in that external rotation. Right arm comes out towards the side. Keep a bend in that elbow and draw the shoulder blades wide here. Spreading that right palm. Rooting to rise. So a steady movement from the shoulder, so the torso is staying steady first. On the inhale, we're drawing that arm back in space. We've already been twists in if you wish. On the inhale, we're opening up to the right and taking the gaze with us. Left shoulder forward, right shoulder back. That's the inhale. On the exhale, twisting again, drawing the hand towards the inner leg or even inner knee. Inhaling and exhaling. So we're getting that gentle twisting motion. If you want to add on, we've already been here too. Inhaling, that right arm comes up and back. And we've got an extension through the heart here. So lifting through that heart space as we gaze to the right. On the exhale, draw the belly in towards the spine as we round the spine, tap towards the inside of the knee, maybe the inside of that upper lower leg. Inhaling and exhaling. It's a big sweeping motion. Keeping your feet and seat connected to the support underneath you. You may notice there's a lot through the side and the back of that right lower back. Inhaling and exhaling. We're getting to the lats and the QLs here in the back body. Extension and flexion in the spines. We're bringing everything we've done so far into this movement. Let's take another two and always rest. Last one. And then if you're not already resting, let's come back to support. Any intuitive movement to release tension is great. If you need to release that external rotation for a bit, go ahead. And we'll move to the other side. So rooting to rise, regulate the breath. And then we're gonna bend that left elbow, draw the palm wide, and draw the shoulder blade on that left side back towards the spine. That's the inhale. On the exhale, keeping the spine neutral, tapping towards the inside of the right thigh. Inhaling and exhaling. Great place to be, just here. Bringing a twist into it, we're gonna open out to the left of the gaze. Slight openness to the chest, we've got a slight extension through the thoracic spine. On the exhale, we're drawing down towards the knee here. So, we're starting to get that little twist involved in the movement. Notice how that feels, always adjusting things for your body here. Adding on. Sweeping that left arm up, we've already been here today, and maybe even back. That's the inhale. On the exhale, curl the belly in, round the spine, ground through that left hip as we reach with the left hand. Inhaling and exhaling again. Notice how you feel this in your body, where you feel it. If you need to make any adjustments for working with your body, keep the breath steady and smooth. Let's take another two here. Be gentle with yourself. Last one, more or less. Beautiful. We're gonna come back to center, rolling through the shoulders. Still staying in that external rotation. Hands coming to rest on the thighs here, or the arms of your chair. And then from here, rooting to rise, regulate the breath if it got elevated in any way. And then with those lower ribs, we're gonna start to rotate the ribs here, nice and slow. So it is a very controlled movement. On the inhale, we have extension through the spine, getting through that lateral flexion as we come around. As we go back, we've got that flexion and continue. Get the shoulders, the head, the neck involved. Allow this to be an intuitive movement as best as you can. Really nice and slow. You can notice the weight distribution as you come from one side to the other of the pelvis, backwards and forwards. You might even notice that the feet are working in harmony here, one pushing down and the other to keep you balanced and coordinated. A great way to find this intuitive movement, if you feel stable, is to close the eyes. Let's take another couple in this direction. You can always rest, of course. This is your practice. And we want that fluidity as much as we can in the body. Next, exhale, we'll pause. And then go around in the opposite direction. Keep it small to start with. Let the body get used to this direction. And then we start to move more intuitively as we allow the body to guide us into what feels best for us. Inhaling and exhaling. Noticing how that feels for you. Take another couple here, smooth it out, slow it down, and then coming all the way back to center, rooting to rise, steady the breath, beautifully done. Keeping that external rotation, getting down into the hips, which we just massaged a little bit, hand towards or on that right knee. You need to come back in space because you want more support, or forward in space, you want less support, go ahead. You can pick up the right toes if you like, the ball of the foot. On the inhale, we take that knee wide, never pushing, just a natural range of motion. Exhaling, drawing that knee down and in any amount. Left leg and your torso not moving. Inhaling and exhaling. Guiding that leg with your hand, the pivot is on the heel, or you can allow that leg to do its own thing if it feels controlled. Getting into the abductors and the adductors here with the movement as we lubricate that hip. Inhaling and exhaling. Beautiful job. Next time you take that knee out, we'll keep it there. Take the foot down, readjust yourself, and we'll come to the other side. Got that foot rooting down. Pick up the toes if you want on the left side or the heel. And we've got this pivot right the way down through the heel if that's comfortable. Steady the breath, and on the inhale, we take the knee wide. On the exhale, we draw it down and in. Inhaling and exhaling, noticing how that feels. Never pushing past the breath and the upper body and that right leg stable and still. Notice what this hip feels like, where you feel it, if you feel it anywhere else as well. Be gentle with yourself. And then the next time that knee comes out, let's leave it there. Foot comes down. And finally, let's take those hips in so the knees are parallel again and wash the knees side to side. That's a lot of external rotation. We spend most of our time in this parallel position, so we really lose that range of motion with the hips, so it's really good to get that in the day at some point, that external rotation. From here, start to steady the breath once more. Readjust yourself on the chair in your posture and smooth the breath out all the way in and all the way out, noticing how that feels for you. And then when you're ready, you're going to slide that right foot forward. Heel comes to the earth. That knee with a nice, gentle, soft bend, and we'll take that heel out towards the side. From here, we're going to circle through that ankle. Once again, make sure that we've got a nice bend in that knee. Spread the toes as they come back towards the shin and point the foot, and then we're getting into the bones of the foot as well. And of course, this is not only the ankle and the foot, this is coming out through the knee and through the hip as well. You can take that finger into the hip joint and notice that rotation. Your heel may travel, so adjust yourself if you need to. Next time though, the ball of the foot comes back, we'll pause and take it in the opposite direction, whichever direction you are going in. Inhaling. just that heel in. Spread the toes really nice and wide. Hands coming to the top of that left thigh, and we're rooting to rise. We've got this length through the torso, making sure that the torso stays as long as possible. This is the inhale. If this feels enough and you're already feeling like it's waking up the back of the hamstrings, the back of the quad, underneath side of the sole of the foot, underneath side of the foot, sole of the foot, then this is where you stay. No need to go further. If you want to, on the exhale with that long spine, just dip the shoulders forward in space a little, push into the hands, and inhale, shoulders back over the hips. So we're just gently waking up the back of that right leg. Spread the toes, push down through the heel, keep a nice bend in that right knee if that feels better for you. And then the option is noticing how your body feels here. If it likes to be in stillness, shoulders over hips, stay. If it likes the easing backwards and forwards, then stay. If it feels good to you, you can come forward and stay for a few breaths here. Belly's drawn in, collarbones wide, gaze is about eye height. And we're breathing, breathe into sensation. Always noticing if you're pushing past the breath, back off a little bit, do a little less rest. Allowing the body to tell you what it needs. Staying for the last exhale, when you're ready, we're going to come all the way back up, and that right knee is going to draw in, just washing that knee in and out a little bit to release tension. We'll come back to those parallel legs. Extending that left leg out in front of us now, heel to the floor, giving a nice bend in that knee, spread the toes, and we're going to send that heel out towards the side. If you do not feel stable and steady, move back in space in your chair to get more support. And we're circling through that ankle. And we've got some snap, crackle, and pops in there today. So again, this is moving all the way from the hip. Don't worry if that heel travels. Readjust yourself should you need to. Pointing and flexing the toes. And then we'll pause and take that round in the opposite direction. Mm-hmm. You feel those ligaments sliding over bone there. Nicely done. And then the next time those toes come up, we'll spread them wide, draw them towards the shin. Nice bend in that knee if it feels very intense, or towards straight, pushing down through the heel. Hands come to support you on that right leg. This may be enough. For a lot of us, this feels already tight through the back of that left leg. If that's the case, you stay here. If you want to add on, this is the inhale and the exhale, draw the shoulders forward, long spine so we're not curling in here, collarbones wide, inhale, push into the hands, draw the shoulders over the hips. So very gentle, rocking forward and back, getting the body used to this. We're waking up the back of that left leg in particular. Tuck the chin, you might even feel this through the back body. Again, long spine. Option to keep moving forward and back. Option to come forward and stay any amount. We've still got that rooting to rise sensation. So the spine is long, belly drawn in towards the spine, supporting that lower back. Keep the breath steady, never pushing past the breath or holding the breath. And then when you're ready, pushing in two at the hands to draw the shoulders over the hips. And we're coming back in space. Take a breath in. Exhale it out. And if you need to release any tension in that left leg, go ahead. Coming into a little more of that hip work, bringing the knees and ankles in towards each other. Sitting back in your chair, if you want a more making sure you feel supported here. And again, sitting back into your chair can help you, as we will be rocking forward and back if you wish to. This is a great place to stay. If you happen to have a yoga block or a stack of supported, stable books, you can take that foot up in space. And that's getting a little more into, of course, that right hip. The higher it is, then the more we're moving into that hip. The other option is, depending on your range of motion, that ankle can come on top of the thigh. If that's the case, once again, we keep a flex in that ankle. And this is going to be a little more intense in the right hip, of course. Left ankle under the knee, so we're not at any kind of odd angles there, keeping the legs supported. This, just like when we were had the leg out in front of us moments ago, can feel very intense. So if that's the case, you stay here. Wherever you are, knee to knee or knee to ankle. This is the inhale on the exhale, if you wish to, rocking forward in space. Inhaling, shoulders over the hips, exhaling, coming forward. And as we come forward, just like with the back of the leg, the hip sensations get more intense. So you ease the body into this, deciding how it feels for you. Option to come forward and stay. Take a few breaths here, close the eyes, soften the jaw. Notice how it feels, make any adjustments if you want to dip deeper or back off. We're here for another couple of breaths. Keep the breath steady and smooth, really feeling into your body here. And after one of your next exhales, we'll draw the shoulders back up the hip, over the hips if they weren't already there. And wherever that leg is, we'll release it. Same thing as we come to the other side, ankles and knees in towards each other. We can take that left foot out, flex in the ankle to come to the outer blade of that foot. If you do have anything supportive that you can take under that left outer leg to lift that foot up a little higher to get into the knee, or get into the hip, excuse me, then that's great. Option to take that left ankle over the top of that right thigh, flex in the ankle to support that knee, keep all those ligaments and tendons nice and tight. Inhaling here. Notice what this feels like in the left hip. If it's too intense, take it down to a previous modification. Hands on your knees or knee to ankle. This is the inhale. On the exhale, if it feels right in your body, rocking those shoulders forward a couple of millimeters, inhaling shoulders over hips. We're just easing the body into this movement. Long spine again, not hinging anywhere up the spine, but hinging from the hips. Mm-hmm. Option to keep this gentle rocking going. Option to come forward and stay for a few breaths. Nice and steady. Steady with the breath. Always listening to your body. Working with it and not against it. And when you're ready, after one of your next exhale breaths, if the shoulders are forward, we'll inhale and release. And release that left leg from wherever it was. Taking the knees side to side again, relieving any tension through the hips. And we're gonna sit all the way back in space here, all the way back. So the pelvis meets the back of the chair unless it was already there. For a lot of us, taking the knees wider, it's gonna make this forward fold a little more comfortable. Just going on what we've done, that rocking forward and back, hands resting on at the top of the legs, and we're rooting to rise. So same basic seated mountain pose that we came through the session with. This is the inhale. On the exhale, bend at the elbows, long spine here. This is the inhale. On the exhale, we're coming forward. the shoulders over the hips. So notice if the tendency is to roll through the spine and see if you can hinge right at the hips, using those hands for support. Option to come forward and stay, any height. Option to come down to forearms, and that's where for a lot of us it's more comfortable to take the legs a little wider. If you're overarching the back here, draw the belly in and strengthen and lengthen the spine. Chin draws in and we've got that long length from the sitting bones all the way through the base of the skull. Option to stay here. If this feels enough, then stay. You can always snuggle your seat back towards the back of the chair to give you more stability. If you want to come further, hands resting on the thighs, and we're drawing the ribs, the belly on the in between those legs or resting on top. Head at heart height, chin drawn in to lengthen the back of the neck. Any head injuries, neck and throat issues, or eye conditions where pressure is involved, this is where you stay. Head stays at heart height. You can take the hands down to support you, down through the legs, the ankles, even the floor. You can, of course, bring the floor up to you with any support. And then the last option here is to draw the chin down towards the chest, and we start to allow our shoulders to round. Hands resting, or you can take opposite elbows, and we're dangling here. Any nausea, any dizziness, hands come up to the thighs, drawing yourself back into the chair and staying there, steadying the breath at any time. Otherwise, no matter where you are, if this feels good in your body, you can give your head, if it's dangling, like a ripe fruit, a little nod or a shake to lengthen through the neck, just gently. And then wherever you are, we're breathing into the back of the ribs here, inhaling and exhaling. Steady the breath, smooth the breath as best as you can. Always making any adjustments for the body, always coming out early if that feels good to you. Let's take another four breaths unless you're resting and coming out early. Noticing how you feel here. Always choosing what feels right for you over any instruction. And then when you're ready, after one of your next exhales, we'll take the hands back up on top of the legs. Tuck the chin in so the neck is long and supported. Push through the hands and bring yourself up, shoulders over hips, and sit back into the chair, sliding the hips forward just a little, and we settle in this very supported seat. Any dizziness, any nausea, rest your eyes on something soft in front of you and steady and regulate that breath. Feel that support of the chair underneath you and allow your body to sit into that. You can stay here. Or if there's any last adjustments you want to take to find yourself in a very restful shape and position. So if there's somewhere more comfortable for you, on the sofa or on the bed, and that feels better for you to rest, please go and take yourself there slowly, gently, and gather around you extra layers, eye pillows, anything that feels good to you here. Settling in to your shape to finish up today. And then, once there, we'll take a big breath in. Exhale it out nice and slow. Let's take another couple of breaths here. and in particular time around the muscles of your forehead, smoothing them out, softening through the brows, releasing all the small muscles around and behind your eyes, allowing the cheeks and chin to unwind as the back teeth part, tongue soft, releasing the jaw. And if you need to, allow that jaw to move around, the bottom jawbone to move around in circles in one direction and the other, go ahead and do that. Another great way to release the jaw is to mouth the word wow, W-O-W, really big, silently, wow. Together on the end and the beginning, and that ow sound, taking the mouth as wide as you can. And then allowing, once again, the back teeth to part and the muscles of the face to soften and let go. Allow that softness to ripple down through your shoulders and torso, arms and legs. Not forgetting the back of your head, neck, and shoulders. And as you allow everything to unwind, allow your skin, the biggest organ we have, to completely relax as best as it can. As if all the cells of your skin just got a little softer. And if you're feeling as if there's anything that you're doing here, see if you can let go of that sensation. We let go of doing so we can simply be. Noticing that gentle, soft breath that comes and goes, that breathes for you. And consider pausing the thoughts on the exhale. So from the top of the exhale all the way down to the bottom, allowing those thoughts to still completely. It's focusing on the length of your exhale, that gentle ebb and flow of the breath. Every exhale, unwinding, letting go just a little more. As you pause those thoughts, and release and relax where you can. Your mind gets caught in a story. Notice it when you do. Release that story and come back to allowing every exhale to pause the thoughts and release the body. And stay here for as long as you like, letting my words drift over you as you deepen into your rest. some lost moments to release any gathered tension in particular areas. Notice the breath as it moves in and out the body naturally, easily, effortlessly. Starting to expand the inhale just a little deeper. Sigh through the exhale. As you take those more mindful breaths, allow any awakening movements to ripple through your body. You may want to stretch wide or long, intuitive movements, or maybe you want to stay as still as you are, staying exactly as you are, wherever you are, deciding on the shape that you wish to finish in, and that maybe again staying as you are or coming up to a different shape. There's no wrong way to finish your practice. Finding your way there over the next few breaths if you are wanting movement. And then wherever we are, we settle into that stillness, acknowledging that support underneath us that we began with. If your hands are drawn to a particular gesture of closing, then please go ahead and naturally allow that to unfold. As we root down into the earth and lift through the heart just gently, on an exhale, drawing the chin down towards the chest, honoring that space within the heart. Big breath in. Exhale it out, thanking yourself for your practice, allowing a sense of gratitude to well within you for this time that you set aside for yourself. From my heart to yours, thank you for being here